Hey, 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 IBOC family. Thank you so much for taking the time to show up, sew up, and serve up.
This is the first Sunday of February, and at IBOC, we are choosing consistency in 2023.
So here we go, family. These are your trending topics for the week. Consistency commitment.
We are going into our sixth week of our 90-day consistency commitment, featuring inspiring videos from our amazing IBOC members. There are so many more to come, and we can't wait to see who's next. So here is your inspiring video for today.
Hi, family. This is Sister Sean Vaden, and today is day 36 of our 90-day commitment. See, you thought I was gonna sing all that. No, I'm just playing. I'm not gonna sing all that. No, seriously. My name is Sister Sean Vaden. I am a proud member of the Inspiring Body of Christ Church for 32 years. Can you believe it? Look at the skin. No wrinkles. Just playing. Listen, today is day 36 of our 90-day commitment, where we are consistently committed to show up, sew up, and serve up. June 7th, 2005, our wonderful pastor, visionary, and leader shared something in a message that resonated with me. And you know what he said? He said, tough times don't last. Tough people do. And guess what? You're a Christian. You're tough. You can outlast any challenge that has been set before you. 1 Peter 4:12 says, beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial, which is to try you, as though some strange thing is happening to you. But rejoice, inasmuch as ye are partakers of Christ's sufferings, that when his glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy. So with that, push through. Keep trying. Don't give up. Live to see tomorrow. God has got your back. Tough times don't last, tough people do. Be sure to tune in tomorrow for another inspiring word from God. Amen, saints.
You can get a daily dose of IBOC inspiration by texting the word commit to the number 31996. Do it today.
Sunday Night Live.
Last week was the kickoff of our very first tithing our time of the year, and even though the weather changed some of our plans, Sunday night service was a University of Dreams takeover. Our third and fourth grade scholars gave us a creative presentation of what show up, sew up, and serve up means to them, and it was amazing. After that, Pastor Rush preached a powerful sermon, and as always, the kids were able to understand and explain what they learned. Great job to all of the scholars who performed. Great job to those who were behind the scenes. And great job to our third and fourth grade teachers, Sister Hillman and Sister Davis. Our next Tithing Our Time series will go back to a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday format, March the 13th through the 15th.
Coming soon.
Every first and fifth Sunday of 2023 will be Super Sunday, meaning we will have one service at 10 a.m., but on the second, third, and fourth Sunday of every month, we are going back to two services. So join us next week and bring somebody with you, 8 a.m. and or 10 a.m. at IBOC. Every first Sunday of 2023 will be Baptism Sunday. If you would like to be baptized, all you have to do is text the word baptism to the number 31996. It is a fun ceremony where we celebrate you being a new creature in Christ. And look, even if you don't register, we'll take care of you. Just come on across the street to the other building, go into the U of D Chapel. IBOC baptism every first Sunday at 2 p.m. To all married couples, we will have IBOC Marriage Enrichment next week at 2 p.m. Married and engaged couples, make plans to come on out and have a good time. Marriage Enrichment next Sunday at 2 p.m.
IBOC shout out.
Shout out to a super U of D fifth grader, Brother Charles Russell. He had surgery last week and he is doing great. He is watching online right now, and we just want to say we love you, man. Shout out to Faith Temple Seventh-day Adventist Church. Pastor Rush was the speaker at their service on yesterday, and God showed out like he always does. We love partnering with other believers, so thank you, Pastor Cox, and thank you, Faith Temple.
And finally,
shout out to everybody who made it through last week's freezing rain. Hopefully you didn't end up like these people. And those are your trending topics for the week.
And all the glory goes to God. Black History Month is a great time to celebrate the excellence and achievements of so many men, women, and children of the past and present. But it's important to understand that Black history goes beyond the names we normally hear about. Today, we would like to continue a new series to recognize Black excellence in our own church family. Throughout the rest of this year, we will highlight our brothers and sisters who are making a difference in our community and making a difference for Christ. One of our very own members is making history every day, and this is his story.
God specializes in using people that everybody else counts out. You know, the kind of people that make you shake your head and say, who would have thought that you would be successful? We traveled all the way to Terrell, Texas to get the testimony of a young man who overcame the odds.
Good morning, IBOC family. I am Deacon Fletcher, and I am a proud member of the Inspiring Body of Christ Church for the past 27 years. And today you're sitting at Lindy Gas and Equipment. We are the world's largest industrial gas manufacturing company, and I have been blessed to work here for the past 23 years. Who'd ever thought a young kid from Pleasant Grove, Texas, would grow up and be in the position that God has placed me in? I had an awesome mother or an awesome father, but at some point in my teenage life, Satan stuck some anger in my life. That anger pushed me into doing a lot of things that I'm not proud of at all. Selling drugs, hustling on the streets. But I truly thank God for a mother, a mom who loved God with all of her heart, a mom who loved this pastor, this man of God. His name was Pastor Rush, and she loved him with a passion, and she asked him if he would help find her son and help her son get his life on track. I was getting ready to make the most financial transaction in my criminal career. And I was getting ready to go to Shreveport, Louisiana. But I went by Townie's mom and I bumped into Pastor Rush. And Pastor Rush boldly said to me, son, whatever you're getting ready to do, death is written all over it. And I just couldn't believe that he would just so boldly come up to me and not really knowing me, just knowing my mom would say something to me like that. But he asked me to come to his church the next day, and I was like, nah, not tomorrow. I got something I need to go take care of. And I ended up going to a 7 o'clock service because I said I can go to 7 and I can get out of 7 and get on to where I need to be. I went to 7 o'clock service and I had an amazing time. And when I got out of church, I realized and got a phone call that two of my closest friends died at that transaction. If it wasn't for Pastor Rush being as bold as he was and listening to what God had to say to him about me, I would not be here today. I've always asked God, what is it that you want me to do? What is it that you want me to be? And God put in my heart and he put in my spirit to start my own security company. And in 2018, I said, God, I can't do this. I have this plant that I have to run. I have a family. I have ministry. All these other things. I have a teenage daughter. God, I can't do this. And he said, you're right. You can't. But I can through you. If you trust me with every dollar, if you trust me with every client, if you trust me with every contract, I'll take you in business places that you've never seen before.
God has fulfilled his promise of taking Brother Fletcher to places that he never even dreamed. But there's a secret place where he loves to go to keep his life centered on God.
Everybody understands or thinks that being a servant is belittling or it's beneath me. And I just want to say that people ask, Fletch, what is your gift? And I always say that my gift that God has given me is to be a servant. When I got ready to put servant on my license plate, and I called and I asked the lady, can I have a 7-letter word? Can I put servant on my license plate? She said, I guess you can, because no one has ever asked to put servant on their car. Everybody wants to have king or baller on their car or whatever. And I was so grateful because God showed me then that everybody won't want to do what you do, but everybody can't get the results that you get. I truly believe he's given it to me because I served my way to the top.
We love you, Brother Fletcher. Thank you for being an example of an amazing Christian servant, and thank you for being an example of Black excellence.